Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. You don't need to believe it unless you have Spirit of God. So let's do Acts 11, verse 1 to 18. Peter reports to the church. Now in these acts, you know, the Messianic Jews, they have made a lot of corruptions. The result was that, you know, that the Martian, when he looked into these acts, he neglected them because they were so, I did not want to do the acts either because there are so much Judaized or corruption brought from the old leaven, which is the written Torah. You know, written Torah is old cloth full of holes, and that have been patched with the New Testament, making the patch worse. However, let's try, you know, to get something out of it. Now the apostles and the brothers who were throughout Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. Now Gentiles, they are the out of 100 sheep, one sheep was lost. The 99 sheep are Gentile. They were already in the royal kingdom of God. And that's why when Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, James and John went to a Samaritan village. And they were so good, they didn't want to know Jesus, you know. They told them, let him go, you know, you're a Jewish man, keep it to yourself. And when Jesus had the chance of going to a Samaritan village, a woman of Samaritan, she wetted Jesus in spirit, and in spirit she said, you are a prophet. Now Jesus told his laborers not to tell anyone that he is the Christ. But to this woman, he was too pleased to tell her that he is the Christ they are looking for. A Jew is valued or appreciated by a jeweler and not those super donkeys carrying holy book at Jerusalem reading Torah and all that and had no value, no spiritual values. So Samaritan had the spiritual values and these things which the Jewish people have put on, you know, that they heard that the Gentile also had received the word of God. There was no surprise for them. It was the Jewish people who were the lost sheep, which refused to have the word of God. They were the worst. And they are telling here that as if the Gentiles were the worst. The Jews, they themselves are anti-Semitic because Abraham was not a Semitic race. Sorry, he was of Semitic race. He was not a Jew outwardly. He was of Semite. So in tribal link, you build covenant with Abraham, not as Jew, because he was not a Jew. So when you break your covenant with Abraham, you break covenant with Yahweh. So both unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, you are anti-Semitic. And these people tell the Gentiles are anti-Semitic, opposite. So be careful of these crooks. And they are the one who have written this Acts and all that. And they are the one who light came among them, and they hated light and preferred darkness. And when they had blind guide leading the blind, they fall into the pits of Holocaust. So you can't blame Hitler for the deaths of the people of Judah tribe, Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe. Not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. So be careful. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcision party criticized him, saying, "You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them." This means, after all the eye-opening by Jesus, that we have one Father, the Jews were still thinking to be superior to the Gentiles. Even though they were fleecing the Gentiles by hook and by crook. The Gentiles were not fleecing them. Jews were fleecing them. That is why James the Just was there to save the Gentile from being fleeced. He used to beg the rabbi, give him his money back. He used to get it back. There's much more than what you read in Acts and other things. So that's why these Acts have been corrupted so much. Marcion refused to put it in his Bible. And no wonder. And I agree with him. No wonder they killed James the Just for telling them this simple gospel truth, that in God there is neither Jew or Gentile. So Jews corrupted the Old Testament as well as the New. But Peter began and explained it to them in order. I was in the city of Joppa praying. Now, Peter was meditating, you know. Peter belonged to supernatural world, not to the natural world. People of natural world, they pray to the natural demiurge God, Yahweh. We belong to the supernatural world, and our Father is God, which is supernatural. He is no more in heaven. He is inside my body. Immanuel. This is the temple of God. He lives in this temple, not in heaven. So we meditate. We find quiet place at night when I sleep. You know, I meditate at that time. When I'm sleeping, or when I wake up early morning, then I think about a problem and I meditate on that one and I get the answer. So you talk it to your own heart, you don't pray. And in a trance, I saw a vision, something like a great sheet descending, being let down from heaven by its four corners. And it came down to me. Looking at it closely, I observed animals and beasts of prey and reptiles and birds of the air. And I heard a voice saying to me, "Rise, Peter, kill and eat." But I said, by no means, Lord Yahweh, for nothing common or unclean has ever entered my mouth." Now, in Jewish people, you know, we have these rabbi who are like our physician, doctor, you know, who will advise people this to eat, this not to eat. So this is kosher, this is not kosher. So that's why, you know, Peter was saying nothing, you know, of which is not clean has entered my mouth. But the voice answered a second time from heaven. What God? This was first one for the natural man, you know, he refused. Now it's giving the spiritual second time, twice born. But the voice answered a second time from heaven. What God? our Father in spirit, are supernatural to natural demiurge Father Yahweh has made clean, do not call common. That means think spiritually, you know, that you are royal priest above the Rabbi, which are priest. So you'd exercise common sense when you eat and clean the animal and cook it properly. There's nothing wrong to eat it. That means we override all the natural law, dietary prohibitions made in the name of Yahweh by the priest of Moses for your physical health, for the once more disciples of the Rabbinic priests. Do not apply to us in our supernatural Father God, in which we are no more the once born disciples of the Rabbis, but free men of spirit who are sensible enough to eat with the necessary precautions or cares in cooking the meat. That means we are supernatural, and these natural laws we override, because least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist, who was ideal rabbi. So you can see what position we have. So we override the law and no more sin but righteousness of heart. We lived in Africa for 14 years. I was lecturer there. And over there, you know, people are eating bush meat, snake, with player, you know, very tasty. And all that, you know, you have snails, everything, you know, they were eating. And they are healthy, because they go by spirit, you know, not by asking a rabbi, shall we eat this one or not. In Africa, the people eat bush meat with player. This happened three times. Third time was for the wise men led by Holy Ghost. And they are free men who are masters of their own destinies and sealed to serve God. Remember, Emperor Nero took the eyes of the Samaritan woman and her brethren in Christ. And they grew up. They cut her arms and other things, you know. After a while, they grew up. She was whole. She was even poisoned by a sorceress that Nero employed to kill her. And she survived. Nothing happened to her. And sorcerer, she was very surprised, you know. I'm giving her poison and she's still there. And even she was killing her, but she preached gospel to that sorcerer. And she also became a laborer. Even Nero's daughter became a laborer of Christ Jesus. So this is the power of the gospel. And remember that, but no harm came to her. That is why some people handle snakes with faith in Jesus, that no harm will come to them. Also, such people walk in the path of our Father and not of the corrupted word of Mammon. You know, those people who are handling snakes and worshipping in churches, do they tell lie? As these people are doing in this Western world. Are they hypocrite? What is inside different from outside? No, they are not. So when you worship God in truth and in spirit, then you are saint of our Most High Father. Remember that Christ Paul, he was bitten by a snake. That was poisonous, you know, and local people were just watching him to die, you know. He will die now and next, Nothing happened to him. They were surprised. So, is this, you know, power of our Father. In God, we worship our Father in truth and in spirit with the impartial heart of a child. That is what they were, you know. And they are here now even worshipping, holding snakes and all that, you know. And all was drawn up again into heaven. That means, and behold, at that very moment, three men arrived at the house in which we were sent to me from Caesarea. So you can see, you know, what Holy Spirit brought him, you know, then. That means after passing this test, you know, then Peter was in the fourth spiritual state, one with God and with the Holy Spirit. Then he went down to greet those three men. And the Spirit told me to go with them, making no distinction. These six brothers also accompanied me. Remember the seven candles of Menorah. Peter represented the middle candle of God. That means Menorah is a Jewish one. So the seven mean that they were Menorah of our Father. Menorah, which is belong to the natural Father Yahweh, with the light of God in the middle. Natural Father is of works. There are six type of works, and the middle one is grace. And that is oral Torah, you know, which was missing in the Jewish people. Jesus came to fulfill that one. So that is supernatural. So when you light the candle, you light it from supernatural Father to natural people. Peter, they are much more, you know, than this one. It, when you get spirit, you know, you can tell many things, and you can't write it in ink on paper, the glory of our Father. And we entered the man's house, and he told us how he had seen the angel of Lord Yahweh stand in his house and say, "Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter, and he will declare to you a message by which you will be saved, or you will get resurrection, you and all your household." Whoever, you know, believed in Jesus, he will be saved. As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell on them because they were already walking in the path of God, loving and helping each other as the Samaritans did. Just as on us at the beginning. So Christ Philip, you know, clearly states, you know, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. It is only the Jewish people who are the lost sheep, to redeem which that Jesus took birth and suffered on the cross. He went to cure them. The sick people took hold of him and killed him. How? As a Lamb of God in their temple, they beat him proper. In his own house, they beat him. That means the whole household and the people whom he had invited became the apostles, spreading good news of the royal kingdom of our Father. And I remembered the word of my anointed twin brother Christ Jesus, and not rabbinic rabbis. Lord. Lord is the word not in our royal kingdom of God. It's only in the kingdom of Yahweh. You have Yahweh is the Lord, and so the rabbis, they are lords. Pope is Lord. in Yahweh, not in our. That's why he killed people. How he said John baptized with water in the name of Abraham, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit in the name of our Father. If then God, our supernatural Father, gave the same gift, Holy Spirit, to them as he gave to us as reward for working in his vineyard, then when we believed in our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus and not Lord of the Messianic Jews, crook Messianic Jews rather, who could stand in God's way? That means God does whatever he likes, you know, he doesn't like command. You can't demand him, you know. You are not working like a laborer, you work and earn your wage. When somebody you employ, you know, he works for you, say 8 hours. For 8 hours he will say, okay, give me this much amount. He will demand, you know. This is not the gospel, is a different, you know, grace. So our Father giveth whatever he desireth, whatever he willeth. We can't any make demand from him. That is, our Father works through grace, and it is his pleasure to give whatever he likes to give you. When they heard these things, they fell silent, and they glorified God, saying, then to the Gentiles also God has granted repentance that leads to life. Bloody hell. The Gentiles were already in the royal kingdom of God. What type of repentance they got? Nothing. It was the Jewish people, the lost sheep. They needed repentance, not Gentiles. They were not lost. So you can see how crook these Jewish people are. The spiritually sick chosen people who killed Jesus, who tried his best to redeem them, the lost sheep, how hypocritically they still think that they are superior to the Gentiles who were not spiritually sick at all, the 99 sheep already in the royal kingdom of God. Christ Philip said, a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So you can see how corruption has been entered into the Acts and New Testament by the Messianic Jews. And that's these, luckily you have got these Gnostic Gospel. You know, everything works according to the plans of our Father, not our plans. Buried in the first century, these books, you know, Nag Hammadi Library or so, revealed when they were needed. 1948, I think it was, 1948 or so, when they found the Nag Hammadi Library, the year when the Israel was established. So now people have got those books, but they are men of letters, no spirit. They are like Jerusalem theologians. To understand these books, you need Samaritans or Gentile like me to give you interpretation. But they hate me. When I go to the university, they say, oh, you have a degree in metallurgy, not in theology. You can't come among us. I laugh at them, you know. However, gospel is a good news, and good news for those who are Gentile and who are illiterate, not for these bookworms of the university professors who are spiritually blind or who are full of the old wine. They cannot desire the new wine on top of it. Our Father God bless you.